Ladies and gentlemen, this is the old set of the 700 Club. You know, there was a big, tall guy who was working in a rehab center in Killeen, Texas. And somehow, he didn't quite know what we'd done to him, but we put him in this chair here. He said, you're the host. I'm leaving the country, so it's your show. And he had this socialite from Dallas, or Houston, one of them. And she had a rock on her finger that was about 7.5 carats sparkling. And Ben was fascinated, like it was a snake down there. He kept looking at it. And then she starts giving her story. He said, you know, you understand, I had such a hard time getting servants. And Ben said, no, I don't know. Tell me about it. I mean, it was... You remember that, buddy?
Indeed, man. Hey, bro, you're looking good, man. For old guy, you look good. Man.
I know. I'm still an old guy, still trying.
Oh, man. You know, I was just sitting here looking at all this incredible equipment here. Hold on just a minute, Pat. Hey, not now, honey. I can't talk to you. But no, you remember, Ben? We got all this fancy equipment here, this, you know, you remember the old, big old, huge, monstrous things they used to wheel around the studio back
in
the day?
And it was a big thing when we got one of them.
When one of them worked, everybody went, hallelujah!
We had a switcher one time. We had Don DeGreat, you know, doing all that stuff. All we could do, we didn't have the ability to fade. And so what we had to do was dip to black on those cameras and come up with another shot, you know. Yes. And so I got on the camera, and Scott Ross was on the switcher. It was fun.
It was indeed. But, you know, man, the thing that you remember most about all that, Pop, you know, we hear people talk about the power of God.
Yes.
You know, but that was and is real. But back in the day, man, I mean, we literally operated every day. And without it, we would not have been able to operate without the power of God. No question about that. No. And it wasn't clearly a matter of what Pat did. It was what God did. And we all just got a chance to be a part of that.
Sheila's here with us, one of our dear co-host. You all gave me all kinds of grief, you know.
Thank you. Thank you. I take that as a compliment.
A wonderful compliment. Total irreverence. You know, give him grief if you can.
You know, the funny thing was, people would write to me and say, how dare you talk to this man of God like that? Yeah. And I'm like, because I love him.
Because we're getting laughs and we're on television.
Ratings, people, ratings. No, but you know, one of my first memories of my first week on the 700 Club, I got a letter from a woman who said, I can tell you love God because I see it in your eyes, but I don't have a clue what you're saying. I think my Scottish accent initially was a little off-putting to some, so I learned to slow down. Oh, don't show that. That's horrible. Oh, that good grief.
That's how you used to love.
That is wonderful.
That was the humidity, people. My hair's not like that anymore.
I want to say, though, Sheila and Ben, that that is one of the perils of working here, as you well know, that there are archives filled with videotape from the past. And Ben, I hate to bring this up, but I really do. But
well, no.
But I'm going. She's got it.
But we found an old tape with you, Pat, with Ben, and with John Gilman acting a little uncharacteristic during a telethon. So let's take a look at that.
I think we're going to have here, go ahead. Louder, boys.
I'm not doing anything.
Here, Ben.
There's no shortage on, there's no shortage on, there's no shortage on smile, and there's no shortage on whatever it is, I know.
Hey, hold the words there.
Right?
Okay, here we
there's
go.
There's a shortage on friendship, there's a shortage on smile, there's a shortage on neighbors, and a million for miles. In heaven for one thing, there's no shortage on, there's no shortage on.
We're not with it, fellas. You're not
into it. Yeah. It's God mercy.
Where are you reading those from? I don't see those words up there.
That ought to be worth $1,000.
I didn't much get with that one, I'm afraid. Hey, you think we're ready? We did that without rehearsing, too.
Everybody will pay $1,000 to give us a stop.
Can I just say that...
You're not quite ready for primetime players.
Yeah. And in fact, that trio would have been in serious trouble without you.
Yeah, you were the only one who got your groove on there, Ben.
And by the way, I didn't sign a release on that, baby. You got problems.
Have your agent call us in the morning.
Have your people get in touch with my people, yeah, right?